9 months after being hit by an earthquake which killed more than 230,000 people and injured 300,000 others, Haiti was struck by a second disaster. In November 2010, a cholera epidemic spread rapidly from the rural districts of central Haiti to the rest of the country. The authorities are responding as fast as they can, helped by international organizations. Handicap International's logistics platform is helping distribute aid to treat infected patients and prevent the disease from spreading. Poor sanitary conditions and a shortage of basic services, like the distribution of drinking water and the treatment of wastewater, do not bode well for the future. Handicap International's mobile teams are responding to the situation by providing cholera prevention advice as part of their work. This disease, which disappeared from the region more than a century ago, is unfamiliar to the population and often gives rise to misunderstandings. These sessions provide people with information and show how, if caught quickly enough, it can be treated relatively quickly, despite being a deadly disease. They also show people how to protect themselves by following a few simple rules of hygiene. Together, health stakeholders in Haiti managed to bring the 2010 epidemic under control. However, the disease is now endemic to certain areas, particularly the most remote parts of the island, such as Martel, in a mountainous region of Grand Goave. Today, several new cases, including one death, have been brought to the attention of Handicap International's mobile team. The team's work consists of identifying possible sources of contamination and reminding local people of advice already given to them by community workers.
Puisque terre, les gros méthodes d'infiltration, quelle que soit de l'eau qui souli, de l'eau à rentrer, mais toute l'eau ça y est, il y a une avec une nappe phréatique à côté, sous-sol, sous-til. Et bien de l'eau ça, c'est de l'eau qui a contaminé.
In addition to its awareness-raising activities, the organization has placed the chlorine container next to the only water point in this village of 1,200 inhabitants. Adding a dose of chlorine to the drinking water enables the villagers to purify the water. As well as dealing with the sanitary emergency, Handicap International continues to run and expand its orthopaedic fitting and rehabilitation projects. The technicians produce permanent prostheses and large numbers of orthoses. The center also offers upper limb prosthesis fitting and runs an everyday life workshop where people learn to perform simple tasks again.
Avant, c'était difficile pour eux de surtout de déplucher une banane. Et quand ils arrivent ici, ils voient que c'est facile. Et ils témoignent ça des fois. Ils disent, ah, je vais faire ça chez moi. Ah, maintenant, je vais pouvoir faire la lessive, faire à manger. Je vais faire à manger, je vais faire de la banane frite chez moi quand je suis arrivée. Il y en a qui disent que qui n'aiment pas demander de l'aide ou qui n'aiment pas demander à quelqu'un de lui rendre un service quelconque. Des fois, c'est gênant pour eux. Si on ne pratique pas, on va quand même, ça va affecter le moral, tout ça. Et quand on a le moral bas, tu vois que.
Islene's situation is particularly tough. She had both of her arms amputated following the earthquake. Before she was fitted with her artificial limbs, she found it impossible to perform everyday tasks. Thanks to her prosthesis and several technical aids, she's gradually won back her independence.
Bon, me sentim bien parce que avant prothèse là c'est eux-mêmes m'a utilisé parce que l'aime de joindre yo ça te fait bien pile parce que l'aime bout ko gagne yo aller m'a regarder moi son monde qui te qu'on a bossé pour moi. Son moun ki te kon ap fon seri de bagay pou mwen ki vle di m te santi m pa bon di tout. Bon, le mal handicap international, la yo te resi ban mwen bagay sa sa yo ban moi yo nou m se senti bien parce que m pran yo m bosser dan bien pou nye a manger à l'aise qui veut dire les mal dans toilette tout comme si que m pa besoin personne ça yo été bien aidé m pile.
Islande has also had to fight to be self-reliant. She was one of the first patients to be fitted with an orthopaedic device by Handicap International. She's now gone back to her studies and is perfectly at ease with her false foot, as they call it here.
Depuis là et pour ça là et pour ça dans l'école là. De voir l'école où doit maintenant tout pour passer. Et pour ça aller.
For Jean-Renaud Bernabé, the father of 10-year-old Reynane, who was amputated following the earthquake, his daughter's education is vital.
No, just let someone know, connect someone, so obligatoire pour voir l'école, son droit parent pour voir l'école. Mais ces problèmes qui viennent arriver, qui viennent cause, moins pas en mesure.
Ces photographies montrent des paysages différents, d'un côté des paysages naturels où la plante pousse seule.
Going to school, finding a job, learning to live in a devastated country, the challenges facing the people of Haiti today are enormous. But these courageous people managed to keep their heads held high, despite their ordeal, as the stories of Islene, Islande, Reynane and many others show. Handicap International continues to work in aid of the most vulnerable people here in Haiti and in all of the countries in which it operates.